Hey there, how's it going everybody? In this video, we're going to be looking at how to read, parse, and write CSV files. Now, if you don't know what CSV files are, it stands for comma separated values. Basically, CSV files allow us to put into a plain text file some data and use some type of delimiter, usually a comma, to separate the different fields. Now, I have a sample CSV file here that we can work with. And if we look at this, then we can see how these are usually structured. So this can kind of look like a mess, but it's not really meant to be read directly. This is just how the data is stored, and then we can use our programs to parse out the information that we want. But we can see that the top line here has our fields. Now our fields in this file are first name, last name, and email. So that tells us the information that we should expect to see on every line. So if I go to the next line here, then we can see that John is the first name and then a comma. Doe is the last name and then a comma. And then this long email here is the email. So that's why these are called comma separated values. And what separates the values is called a delimiter. So the comma is a common delimiter, but you can use just about anything. So sometimes you'll see files with tab delimited values or dashes or things like that, but they're all called CSV files. So now let's see what it's like to read, parse, and write to CSV files. So I have a file here called parsecsv.py. And within this file, we're just going to import CSV. Now you may have looked at that data and wondered why we're just not using the strings split method on each line of the file to parse out the data. And you could do that, but the CSV module just makes parsing these files so much easier. So for example, if someone puts a comma or something in their name for some reason, then we wouldn't want to split on that. And also the CSV module will handle new lines and all those things. So it just makes it a lot easier to parse out all the information that we want without writing something complicated from scratch. Okay, so to read this CSV file, we're just going to open this file just like any other file. So we'll use a context manager here and we'll say with open. And the name of that file that I was just looking at is names.csv. And it's in the same directory as the file that I'm currently writing. And we want to read this file. So we'll put an R there as the second value. And now what we want to call this. So we'll say CSV file. So to read this file, we can say CSV reader, and that can be any variable name that you like, but that's what I like. And then we can say CSV, and then use this reader method, and then pass that CSV file in to that reader method. Now in the background, that reader method is using something called a dialect that has some preset parameters for what it expects the format of our CSV file to be. So by default, it's expecting values to be separated by a comma and a few other things that we'll look at in just a bit. But since our CSV file is pretty simple, we don't need to pass any additional arguments right now. So the CSV reader variable that we just created is going to be something that we need to iterate over. So for example, if we just print this out as is, so print CSV reader and run that, then we can see that right now it's just an object in memory. So instead, we need to loop over all these lines in the reader and see what we get. So we can say for line in CSV reader and then print out each line and we'll run that. Okay, so that looks better. So each line that we're printing out is a list of all the values. So the first value in the list is the name, is the first name. The second value in the list is the last name, and the email is the third value. If I scroll all the way up to the top, you can see that our first line is the field names. So it tells us that the first value is first name, last name is the second value, and third value is email. So for example, if we're going by the index, like this would be index 0, then 1, and then the email would be index 2. If we only wanted to print out all of the indexes, then on this line here, we could say, let's print out index 2 of each line. And if we run that, then we can see that now we get all of the emails printed out. Now, if you don't want this first line of the field names and only want the values, then we can just skip that first line. So if anyone has seen my video on generators, then we can actually step over values in an iterable by calling next. And running next will return the next value if we want to capture that in a variable. But if we just want to step over the value, then we can come up here before our list. We can just say next CSV reader, and that will loop over that first line. And then when we iterate through this, it should start at the second value, which is the first person in the list. So now if we rerun this and scroll up to the top, now we can see that John Doe is now the first value. Okay, so now let's see how we can write to a CSV file. Now we can do this with any list of values, but since we already have a list of values here from our original CSV file, let's go ahead and just use those. So let's say that we wanted to save the same values into a new CSV file, but use dashes instead of commas for the delimiter. Now dashes probably isn't a great delimiter, but I just want to show you something that happens when we do this. Now first, we're going to want to write the field name headers into the new file. So let's take out this next statement where we're skipping over those. So now I'll come down here. And now actually above our loop, we're going to want to open a new file for writing. And so we'll say with open, and we'll call this file new_names.csv. We want to open this for writing, so the second argument is a W. Then we'll say as, and we'll just call this variable new file. And to write to this file, we're going to use a CSV writer. So we can say CSV writer, and that can be any variable name, but that makes sense to me. And we'll do CSV, and then use this writer method, and we're going to pass in new file to that writer method. Now, if we left it like this, then it would just write the same comma separated file that we currently have now. But if we want to use dashes as our delimiter, then we need to pass that in as an argument. So it's going to be the second argument to that writer method. And we can say delimiter equals, and we'll just go use a dash. Now we want to write each line of our original CSV file into this new file. So let's indent our for loop over here so that now we're within the context manager of this new file. And for each line in this CSV reader, which is our original file, we want to write that to a new file. So we can do that by saying csvwriter.writeRow. And the row that we want to write is that line from the original reader. So real quick before I run this, we are opening the original file to be read, and then we're creating this CSV reader variable, and we are using the csv.reader method to read that original CSV file, and then we're opening a new file for writing called newnames.csv, and then we're creating a CSV writer variable, and we're using this writer method of the CSV module to open up a writer using that new file with a delimiter of a dash. And then for each line in this original CSV data, we are writing out to the new file each line of the original file. So now if we run this, then we don't have any output here at the bottom, but it should have created this new file called newnames.csv. And I'll go ahead and open that up. Now we can see in this new file that it's using dashes instead of commas for the delimiter. Now this makes it pretty hard to read, but I wanted to show you what it did with two of our values here. So in our first value, the email actually contained a dash. So we can see here that our CSV writer knew to put quotes around the email since it can't contain that delimiter. And that's so when the CSV is read back in, that it would know that the email is one whole value and that it shouldn't be split on the dash within the email itself. And likewise here, we can see that our second person here has a hyphenated last name of Smith Robinson. So again, the CSV writer knew to put quotes around the last name so that it can tell the difference between the delimiters and the values that just happen to contain dashes. So now that we've seen how that works, let's actually change this delimiter for the new file to something that's a bit more common. So aside from commas, tabs are very common delimiters. So let's use tabs instead. And in Python, a tab can be represented with this backslash T. And if we rerun that and then open up the new names file again, then we can see that now all the values are separated by tabs instead. And that's a lot more easier. That's a lot more easy to read. Now, just like we passed the delimiter into our writer, if we wanted to read in that tab delimited file, then you could pass the delimiter argument into the reader as well. And real quick, let me show you what that would look like if we tried to read a CSV file with the wrong delimiter. So let me copy part of this here where we're reading in this file. And now I'm just going to comment out everything else for now. Now, instead of reading the original file names.csv, we're instead going to read the new tab delimited file that we just created, which is new_names.csv. Now, let's pretend that we forgot to specify the tab delimiter and just tried to read this as is. So let's print out the lines that we get from this reader. So we'll say for line in CSV reader, and we will print out each line. So we can see that each line only has one value, and it didn't split on the values on the tab because it was expecting commas. So instead, you have to explicitly pass in that we want the delimiter to be a tab. So I'll pass that into the reader method here and say delimiter equals a /t for tab, and then rerun that. And now you can see that we get the correct parsing. Okay, so now I'm going to delete these lines here and uncomment out what we had before. Okay, so the way that we've been working with CSV files using the reader and writer is probably the more common way to work with CSV data, since they're the first things that come up in the Python documentation. But my preferred method is working with CSV data using the dictionary reader and the dictionary writer. So let's take a look at those, and I'll explain why I prefer them over the regular reader and writer. Okay, so first let's take a look at the dictionary reader. So to use this, we're just going to replace the regular reader method here with a dict reader. And now let's print out the lines that we get with this. So I'll say for line in CSV reader, and we'll just print out each line. Okay, so at first glance, this may look a little more complicated. Each of the values is now an ordered dictionary. And if we scroll up here to the top, then we can see that that first line no longer contains the field names. It starts off immediately with the first person. So the reason is that the field names are now the keys of each of these values here. Now, the reason that I like this is because it makes it a lot easier to parse out the information that we want. So, for example, remember when we used the regular reader? If we wanted to print out the email address, then we printed out the second index of our line. Well, for anyone reading your code, it isn't obvious what that second index is. So they'd have to go into the CSV file to find that information out. But now that we have those fields as our dictionary keys, then we can get the email here by saying, I just want the email of that line. So we just access that key. So now if we rerun that, then we can see that now we have all of the email information. Okay, and now let's look at how to use the dictionary writer. So I'm going to remove this loop and then uncomment out the rest of this information here. Now with the dictionary reader, we really didn't need to change anything, but with the dictionary writer, we actually have to provide the field names of our file. So one line above our writer here, I'm just going to create a list of the field names. And now instead of using this writer method, we're instead going to use dict writer. Now, one thing that we need to change here is that after the file that we're going to be writing to, we need to pass in those field names. So I'll say field names is equal to field names. Okay, and now we're ready to write the data. So with the dictionary writer, you have the option of whether or not you want to write out those headers, which are the field names in the first row. So if we want those headers, which most of the time I do, then we can say CSV writer dot write header. So that's going to write out those field names as the first line. And once the header is written out, we can loop through the lines of the original file, just like we did before, and say CSV writer dot write row, and then pass in that line. So all of that stays the same. So if we run this and then look over here at our new names CSV file, then we can see that that still worked. And like I said before, the reason that I like working with the dictionary reader and writer is because it's more obvious what you're doing. So let's say, for example, that in our new CSV file, we actually only wanted the first and last names and wanted to leave off the email. Well, with the regular reader and writer, we'd be modifying the indexes of those lists. And like I mentioned before, it's not obvious by looking at an index what value it's supposed to hold. But with our dictionary writer, we can just remove the email from the field names up here. And before we write each line within our loop here, we can just remove the email key and value. And one way to do that is to just delete it. So we can say delete the email of that line. So now when it writes that row, it's only going to be writing the first name and the last name, and the email no longer exists. So now if we save that and run it, and then I open up the new names.csv file here, then you can see that now we just have a tab delimited file of first names and last names, and that email is no longer there. Now, there are several ways that we could have written this row. We could have deleted the email key from the line, just like we did here, or we could have created a new dictionary with only the first name and last name keys and passed that into the write row method. So whichever way works for you. In this case, I think it was easier just to remove the email key. Okay, so I think that is going to do it for this video. I hope that now you have a pretty good idea for how you can read, parse, and write CSV files. But if anyone does have any questions about what we covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comments section below, and I'll do my best to answer those. And if you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then there are several ways you can do that. The easiest ways is simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also, it's a huge help to share these videos with anyone who you think would find them useful. And if you have the means, you can contribute through Patreon, and there's a link to that page in the description section below. Be sure to subscribe for future videos, and thank you all for watching.